Hi everyone, my name is Gayle and thank you for joining the DC Public Library for how to make tissue paper craft jars. What you'll need for this craft is a jar. I love this craft because we can make the most out of old pasta and jam jars many of us already have at home. I'm using a leftover plastic peanut butter jar. Glass jars work great too. Next, you'll need Mod Podge. Or you can actually make your own Mod Podge if you don't have it at home with some regular old glue like this. You would just mix 1 cup of glue with 1/3 cup of water, and that's how you make Mod Podge. Next, you'll need a sponge brush. You can also use a paintbrush to apply the glue, or even a Q-tip, or really whatever you have lying around at home. And of course, you'll need some tissue paper. I already cut mine up into squares. Once you've gathered your supplies, you're ready to start gluing your tissue paper on the jar. And this is the fun part because you get to be really creative and decide how you want your jar to look. You can create patterns with colors or shapes. I'm going to be choosing some oranges and reds because I want my jar to remind me of fall. And I cut my tissue paper up into squares like this, but you might also try cutting them into circles or rectangles to create a really different look. All right, so I'm ready to get started. So here we go. I'm just gonna start applying some Mod Podge and then placing it on my jar. And I'm just gonna be really random with how I put mine on there, but like I said, you might try doing some patterns or designs in there. I've seen lots of cool ways this can be done. All right, so I'm gonna pause the video and keep gluing my tissue paper on there, and I'll show you how it turns out when I'm done. All right. So now I've got my tissue paper glued onto the jar, and I've waited about 10 minutes for it all to dry. And the final step is just to go over all the little loose ends of tissue paper with your Mod Podge with one final top coat, just like this. You just want to get all the little loose edges and make it look nice and even. Here's what my jar looks like now that the top coat of Mod Podge is dry. Now I could stop here. It already looks really nice. Or if I wanted, I could get creative with other objects. Right now it's fall and there are lots of pretty leaves on the ground. So you might go outside and find some leaves you could glue onto your jar. Here's one I found. That might look nice if I glued that on. Or you might also try cutting objects out of construction paper. Here's a leaf I cut out of red paper. I could try gluing that on. I also cut out a tree just to see what that would look like. The possibilities are really endless. Now, what to use the jar for? Well, it would make a great craft supply holder. It also makes a really pretty lantern if you place a candle inside of it. Be sure to ask a grown-up for help if you're using a real candle. I have an electric tea light that I'm going to place inside mine. And for even more inspiration on what you could use your jar for, I recommend checking out the picture book In a Jar by Deborah Marcero. It's a story about two bunnies who collect extraordinary things inside jars. that help them remember all the wonderful things they've seen and done together. It's a beautiful picture book, and I highly recommend checking it out. Thank you again for joining DC Public Library today for how to make tissue paper craft jars. Find more great resources to watch, read, listen, and learn at dclibrary.org.